Hello there and welcome to this expert talk. I'm Yannick Peterschmitt and today we will talk about key innovation for our partners I'm really excited about. SAP now offers different options for partners to add their industry and specific knowledge to build additional functionality on top of Cloud ERP. So we will jointly explore the different options and dive deeper into one option that was released in December 2024, which we call Partner Scalable Delivery Options, using our 3SL test, demo, and development system offerings. I'd like to welcome on stage our two experts, Helmut and Oren, and I'll ask you to introduce yourself, guys, please. Let's start with you, Helmut.
Yeah, thank you for having me. My name is Helmut Hofmann, and I'm heading the Partner Extensibility and Ecosystem Enablement Program, which is a program that we run in the S4HANA engineering organization to enable our partners to extend the SAP S4HANA.
Thanks for being with us, Helmut, and welcome to you, Oren. Pleasure to see you again.
Same. Thank you for having me. Oren Shatil, I'm part of the product management organization within SAP Business Suite. My focus is on extensibility, the various options that we have, making sure that the partner have what it takes to build extension based on the use cases and also the experience that our customer have consuming those extensions.
Okay, cool. Oren, you know what? Let's start with extensibility. Can you please share the different use cases, how you see them on the market from building scalable partner businesses, adding scope, adding field, adding industry content, eventually mention a bit the opportunity maps for the partners who are listening to this expert talk.
Yeah, so we see four use cases. So the one is basically adding scope. So adding something like an industry on top of our line of businesses, this will be the adding scope. The second one will be extending the reach. So basically, we have the end-to-end process, but we want to add a mobile as an example or scanner solution. That will be the extend reach. And then optimize a pre-delivered end-to-end process that need to be customized or need to be extended in a way that a specific customer need can be addressed. And then lastly, around innovation, if we want to add automation or we want to add intelligence innovation, like building an AI agent or just automating a manual task, for an example.
Okay, so to summarize, four different use cases. Now, Helmut, I'd be interested in understanding the different technology that SAP offers to support the use cases. And how can the partner or the customer solve their business problem with that? Can you please share more information and especially highlight, you know, when to choose what technology? Because as SAP, we have many.
Yes, happy to do that. So we see that if we look at our customer system, that almost every customer is using some ways to extend the SAP S4HANA public cloud solution. And we see that this is obviously a very important part of how SAP S4HANA Public Cloud is being used. So we provide really extensive, complete extensibility capabilities. First of all, we of course have our SAP BTP platform as the extensibility platform for the SAP solutions. That's a perfect platform to build complete UIs, mobile applications, analytical applications, complete solutions, extensions, and even things like artificial intelligence use cases. But we also know that there are use cases where it's better to build the extension embedded on the SAP S4HANA on the cloud stack. And for that, we also offer capabilities. For example, if you want to just add a custom feed to an existing process, or you want to change the existing logic just a little bit, or you want to adapt an existing UI or create a couple of analytical use cases. In many cases, it's also something which is combined, where I do, for example, analytical analysis of the data, which is on the SAP S4HANA public cloud. And then I use that as an input for an AI use case on the SAP BTP platform. Yeah, on both sides, we offer low-code, no-code solutions for the business users so that, for example, someone working in accounting or in purchasing can create their analytical queries or their UI adaptations that they need to make their job easier and more productive. On the other side, we also offer on both sides the full-blown development experience for someone who's really used to writing coding in a programming language with all those different tools that are well established for developers. And of course, now we also have AI capabilities with a tool for developers where you can very easily create complete extensions with the help of AI.
Okay. Thanks, Helmut. I guess the big picture is clear now. Thanks for explaining this. You mentioned the embedded options, and I understand that now we have newly released Scalable offering also as embedded option in S4HANA Public Cloud. Could you provide more details on that one, on especially highlight the embedded options and eventually go deeper on the newly released solutions?
Yes, happy to do so. We have been talking to our partners and customers, and we learned that most of those extensions which are done in the customer systems are actually developed by a partner. So we thought about, okay, what do we need to do so that we really meet the needs of the partners who want to provide those extensions? And we came up with three different use cases. The first is the one-off use case, where we see that an extension is built for just one customer, but in many cases, even that situation, the extension is built in a separate system so that you don't compromise the productive system, but you build in a separate system, and then you have the ABAP gate to transfer that extension from the separate system into the productive landscape. If I want to sell the extension to more than just one customer, we have the multi-off solution, where the extension is then stored in a Git repository and can be distributed to many customers, several customers. And we have quite a few customers, partners who are doing that already, who have built some extensions where it's for a specific industry solution or in a specific region where probably the number of customers is not going into the two-digit numbers, but where there is a small but number of customers for which these extensions are very important, and there the multi-off solution is exactly the right solution to that, and it's available for around about 2 years. But we also got the feedback from our partners that, yeah, if I want to scale it to more customers, if I don't want to have whatever 5 or 10 customers, but I see a solution which is going to be used by hundreds of customers, then we need a more complete lifecycle management, a more complete development process. And that's what we offer now since end of last year with the Scalable solution, which is using the add-on assembly kit as a service, as a means to provide add-ons for the customers from the partners that then can be easily managed, installed, deployed, updated, and so on.
Okay, nice. So one-off, multi-off, and Scalable now. Oren, what are the prerequisites and how do we start if you want to build on Scalable, which is the last option?
Yes, so based on what Helmut explained, I want to kind of give an overview of what we have for partners in general, and then specifically what are the prerequisites for multi-off and Scalable. So as we look, you can see in the back end, we have the SAP demo environment 2.0. This offering is something you can order today as a partner, as a partner that is a sell and service partner, and you can order the system. You will have the end-to-end scenarios built into that and use it for your demonstration. Again, this is not customizable, but you can use it out of the box straight away with the very rich demo data. As we look at multi-off, the offering that Helmut explained, the one system landscape TDD test and demo development environment is available to purchase. And this is basically the prerequisite in order to build a multi-off solution for partners. And then lastly, the newly announced three system landscape test and demo development environment, which is the prerequisite for the Scalable solution. You can order it, start building it, and you go along the three landscape in order to build a solution, test it, and then showcase it in the third landscape environment. And those are basically the three offering we have for partners, for build partners, for services partners, both for their demonstration demo need and also to build extensions.
Cool. Thanks for sharing that with us. So, Oren, you just mentioned the technical requirement to get the things going, to get the things done. Is there also a place for partner to start exploring the documentation and actually like a step-by-step journey so you can take the partner by the hand and help him through the different phases because this is completely new for them?
Yes. And here I'm very excited to actually share something new that will be available in the next few weeks for you to click on, basically. This is the partner journeys that we define, and we claim those discover to build, build to publish, and lifecycle management and support along a journey of a partner to explore the use cases, start building the extension, and then while publishing it in the store or selling it directly to the customer, but also the lifecycle management and support. So along those journey, when you look at Discover to Build, we will help partner with the decision. We will have a questionnaire to help them decide based on resources or based on how we they want to deploy the solution, how many customers they are planning to have, what is the business case. So this will be kind of the Discover to Build in order to take the right decision. And again, we will have a step-by-step explanation on where to go next. And then when we look at Build to Publish, also how to become the right partners, how to certify the solution, all of this will be explained in along those journeys. Again, and then specifically once you decide which technology to use, you will have a very specific step-by-step guide in how to go along the technology you chose based on what we explained before. And then, of course, as you build the ABAP development kit and all the things that you need to do in order to build the extension based on what you chose. And lastly, of course, the lifecycle management and support, because we will have a different variation of lifecycle management, whether it's a scalable solution or a multi-off, there is different ways that we want to offer the support. So also this will be explained, and we will make this available in the next few weeks to click. We will also add it to the video once it's available.
Okay, cool. I guess the partner will appreciate a lot that it's all there to help them, to guide them. But for guys like me, you know, seeing is believing. And for the partners too, would you have like a demo that partner can access right away and, you know, click through it just to get familiar with it?
Sure. And what we have done, actually, we created a 5 minutes demo, including the explanation that will be available. Once the video is available, there will be a link that you can click on and basically run this demonstration. And also beside that, of course, help.sap.com is where you can start the journey.
So it looks like the partner will be completely equipped very, very soon. Thanks a lot. Yes. This is very promising. Where to go for more information? You just mentioned that. Help.acp.com.
Correct.
And the blog. Oren, yes. Helmut, that was very compact information on a topic that I feel will completely then change the journey of many partners and how they produce or they build content and share it with the customers. I think this is a great news for them. Thanks for joining this expert talk. Thanks the audience for watching. I'd like to invite you to stay in contact with our SAP experts, visit the SAP community, and if you like this video, leave us a comment, click on the like, and of course share it with your network. You can also contact us via insidess4@sap.com. Thanks for your time, and hope to see you soon.